Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. And today I wanted to do a tag video because I was tagged by the lovely Marie from I'm Bag Happy. And I thought, wow, this is going to be a good way to, you know, come back to filming. I haven't filmed in a long time. So I thought that this would be a great opportunity to do that. I was stuck in a rut for a while. I wasn't sure what I wanted to do or wanted to film. So when Marie tagged me, I was like, perfect timing. So I've been thinking about coming back to filming. I just didn't know how to restart. Anyways, this tag was originally done by Patricia KLM, who then tagged Marie, and then Marie tagged me. So I'm gonna try and link the videos of the two ladies in the description box so that you can go ahead and check those out as well. Forgot to wear my watch. Anyway, so the tag is all about my neglected bags, and I don't really have a very extensive bag collection, although I have to say that there is quite a few. I am going to categorize the bags in, I guess, four different categories. So let's start. I'm going to start off with my Longchamp Le Pliage backpack. It's very small. It folds and it's kind of dirty right now. We probably can't see it because the light is washing it off. But obviously, because of the pandemic, there hasn't been much traveling going on. But I do like to carry this with me when I'm carrying my camera, which is what I'm filming on right now, which is a Canon EOS M6 Mark II, because I like taking pictures when I travel. So I do that alongside with my iPhone. But yeah, because we haven't really traveled much, I haven't really used this. This usually would be like when I was still cycling quite a bit. I would also carry this to put in my water bottle or whatever light items that I need to bring with me. I'm actually contemplating on buying the tote because sometime this year I'm planning on going home to the Philippines. So that's that. So this one has been in the back burner because travel just has not been available to us for a while because of the pandemic. So that's one that's been neglected. And then there are bags that are trendy. So I'll start off. This one is which is a belt bag. This is by Coach. It's from the men's section, the Rivington belt bag. It's a little bit larger. I never wear this around my waist anyway. I actually usually wear this like so. And when I am going around on my bicycle, I like to carry this because it keeps me hands-free. It doesn't add additional weight on me. I don't have to worry about it falling off. So, but I haven't been cycling for a while. And when I do, I just don't carry anything with me apart from my phone, which is stationed on the bike itself. So I haven't really been using this much. Actually contemplating on selling it on, but I also know that when I go visit the Philippines, I am probably gonna bring this with me. Because like when I go to the markets and, you know, I wanna have some bag that is inconspicuous, you know, so I'm gonna call too much attention to myself. And also something that I can keep very close to my body. So this could actually also go on the travel category. Next. This one is a recent purchase, but I've only ever used it once since purchasing it. And I think I just sort of like got carried away by the trend. And this is the Mimco denim bag. It's a cutie, don't get me wrong. It's beautiful. But if I'm being honest, I think I bought it because I love the chain so much. It was a pretty good purchase. It wasn't too much, but it also doesn't carry much. It fits enough of my essentials, really would qualify as a mini bag. But yeah, I again haven't really had much opportunity to actually use this, go out with it. There you go. So it has been neglected. It's very trendy. I don't know how long the denim trend is going to last. I know that several brands are coming out with it. I know there's a tote and a chain bag from Karl Lagerfeld that I am interested in. The chain bag is very much like a Chanel flap bag, denim with, I got turned off by the pearls that was on it. If I still have the photo, I'll put it up on the screen, but it was a really nice bag, and it was like something like 350 Australian dollars, which is a fraction of what a Chanel bag costs. And we all know that Karl Lagerfeld was the creative director of Chanel for like, what, two or three decades, I think it was. So there we go. Anyways, yeah, back to this. Denim, I don't know. Might have some more use for it now that we're coming into winter because of the dark color. But yeah, not, haven't really gone out much with this. Next category is a regret purchase. And the reason why it's been neglected is because I just don't like the design of it, or in terms of functionality, and I'll show it to you. And this is a very beautiful bag. When I first saw it, I fell in love with it. I kept going back to Coach. So this is the bag. And if you're familiar with the Hermes Evelyn bag, this is what it kind of reminded me of. It's a beautiful bag, but my gripe with this is I kind of wish that this was just a magnetic closure or a clasp, because it's a zip. Let's see here. If I wanted to carry anything taller than this, which is about 9 inches, I wouldn't be able to close it. So it kind of defeats the purpose of that, and my OCD just can't take it. If I'm carrying this with, let's say, an umbrella, the handle of the umbrella would be poking out, and it just kind of annoyed me. I prefer to carry my Saint Laurent bucket bag for those purposes. So it's beautiful, it's tricolor, it comes from their 1941 collection. You can tell that by the hand tag there having that metal side. It is genuine glove tanned leather, which is to me the best leather that Coach makes. I also bought it for a really good price, like 50% of what it was on retail, but I just never use it, and I don't know why. I also think that maybe the color is too warm for me. I don't really dress in a way that leans either warm or cool. It's more neutral most of the time, like you can tell, black and cream. Yeah. So yeah, I don't know. I don't know why, I just don't reach for it. And also, there's nothing in it, but it's already quite heavy because it's all leather. There's even the inside lining is suede leather. So yeah, I guess that's also one of the reasons why. But it's a very comfortable bag to use. You can tell that the structure is still there because I haven't used it. Right. And then the next ones, well, this one I know why. It's been trumped by other bags, other wallets and chain. This is my Coach wallet and chain. There we go. Beautiful piece of leather. The inside is smooth, the outside is grained leather, has got silver hardware, comes with a leather strap, but I also have bought a silver chain from Coach to go with this. They match perfectly. But because I have two Chanel walks, one is the boy walk and then the other one is the classic walk, they are both in black though. So I figure that, oh, I could use a light colored walk. But then my YSL clutch, the wrist one, when I put a gold chain on it, it actually works just as well as this. So I'm actually contemplating on selling this. I haven't decided. I might, but we'll see. But it's just, this wok is actually much more functional than the Chanel one, because for one, it's got a full pocket at the back that's actually useful. It's not just cards that you can fit in there. I can fit my entire phone in there. Yeah, it's got really good compartments, and I don't know why. I just don't carry it. I'm also quite afraid that because it is a light taupe color, that color transfer could happen. I think I had that incident already once, but I managed to be able to buff it off, but there was like a transfer from my jeans on this one. Speaking of color transfer, this is another one, and this is probably the only luxury one in the bunch, and you probably would notice that I haven't really used it, and it is my Chanel 19 in the dark beige color. I still have a mask here from way. So I haven't worn. It's larger than the usual bags that I would use. Recently, I've just been gravitating towards wallets and chains and mini bags. So this is larger than what I would normally use. The chain is a little bit heavy, but there's nothing in here except for the chain and some bubble wrap to keep it from getting deformed. But yeah, I just haven't been using it. I also had a little bit of a jeans transfer here at the back, so I think that's also kind of scared me a little bit in using this. And I also noticed that the corner of the flap right there is also has kind of rubbed off, so there's a little bit of wear and tear that I could see there, and I think that made me stop using this for a while, because I just kind of was afraid that I was going to damage it more. I got a little bit of a scratch on there already. Yeah, and because this is such an expensive bag, I think that's what it is. I've just been too precious with it. I usually would say, oh, don't be precious with your bags, you bought it to use it. But honestly, I think I've been too precious with this one, so I haven't actually used it much. It's beautiful. The lambskin is just, or no, I think this was goat skin. Yeah. The goat skin is just really, really nice, but I'm just afraid that I am going to ruin it. So it's been sitting there in its dust bag. Yeah, I think I need to bring it out a little bit more. I think I need to use it more often. Yeah. Surprised? Yeah, I am too. When I was looking at my collection, I was like, which ones haven't I used for a while? And yeah, when I realized that I haven't been using this, like, you would have seen photos of it on Instagram, but it's like I go grab coffee and I bring this just so I can take a photo of it. Yeah, but it's not because I've actually, you know, gone out, run errands and stuff and use it the entire day. No, it's just for show. That's what Instagram is anyway, right? Yeah. Anyway, so those are my neglected bags. Yeah, let me know in the comment section below which bags you have neglected. Are you pretty good at rotating your bags? And like, what do you do when you realize that you've neglected your bags? Do you keep them? Do you sell them? What do you do? Or do you just consciously try to rotate them in your collection? Let me know. And I am tagging. I know that Ron of Rami Rafi and Kenny have already been tagged by Marie as well. So I'm tagging anyone who actually wants to do this.